हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, सॉरी फॉर द इंटरप्शन इन आवर लास्ट लेक्चर इनटू द इंस्टॉलेशन ऑफ वर्डप्रेस पार्ट टू. वॉइस इज नॉट रिकॉर्डेड प्रॉपरली, सो अगेन आई एम री रिकॉर्डिंग द एंटायर सेशन एंड रिप्रेजेंटेटिंग द इंस्टॉलेशन स्टेप इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू. वी वेर ओवर हियर इनटू द प्रीवियस पार्ट ऑफ द लेक्चर फॉर यूनिट नंबर टू. Means we have created one database called WordPress into the phpMyAdmin, which is blank, and by just pressing localhost 8081/WordPress, it shows this menu onto the screen. Now, into the features of WordPress, as we have discussed that WordPress is a multilingual functionality features, so it supports multiple languages of multiple countries, but we are going to select the language called English United States. Just press continue. In next step, it asks for the site title. Into the site title, you can give any site title. For example, suppose I am giving a site title called MVM College. Then give a username as admin. Password you can kept any, but I suggest to keep it very simple, that is called as admin itself. So username is admin, even the password is admin. Just click on this button called confirm use of weak password, because the password whatever we have mentioned over here is a weak password which is indicated into the red title. Don't worry about this, just click on that particular checkbox. And into the email ID, you can write your mail ID. I am writing my mail ID called mvmwordpress@gmail.com. And then in the last option, search engine visibility, discourage search engine from indexing this site. Click on that particular checkbox and press install WordPress. Now, depends on your system configuration, the entire process will take a time, so be patient and wait for the next menu to come in front of the screen. Now once the every process gets successfully completed, we'll receive a message called WordPress has been installed successfully, thank you and enjoy, with username admin and password will shown as a blank. Just click login over here. It returns a one login box onto the screen. In that login box, type username called admin, which we have kept at the installation time. Then, as a password, also type admin and press login. Once everything is proper, a dashboard of WordPress will be returned onto the screen, which looks like this. If this dashboard came in your computer, rest assured that WordPress installation gets successfully completed in your system and we can start using the entire tool for the other purposes. So students, these are the installation steps that we have to perform for installing and configuring WordPress in our local system and into the college. Whenever the practical gets started in the college, this tool is already installed in all the computers. You just need to enter your username as that is admin and password that is admin into the college. So just try yourself how to install WordPress into the system and get back to the practical work. We'll continue our today's session for the other miscellaneous topics also. Like, first we are starting with the post. Post and page are the two major concerns into the WordPress. Whatever we are visiting over the browser with the content, where the content may be a data, data can be in any format, like it might be a text, it might be a number, it might be an image, it might be a symbol, it might be a voice, it might be a video, or lastly, it might be the combination of everything. That is called as content. Now this tool will organize all these contents according to the needs. Keep one thing in your mind while we are handling the subject called WordPress.